Is your shoulder killing you after your chest workouts? Then you should check out this video. Hi, I'm Dr. Joe DeMarco, chiropractor and owner of OcraMed Health. I'm sure there's a lot of you out there that have experienced anterior shoulder pain following a chest workout. Now, I don't care whether you're a power lifter and you're in the gym doing a lot of bench press, or you may just be someone in there doing a lot of dumbbell type of presses, or maybe you're a body athlete doing lots of push-ups. But following those type of workouts, a lot of times the next day, you put some pressure into the front of the shoulder and it's really sore and painful. I mean, sometimes it can be absolutely debilitating. You can wake up the following morning and you feel like you can't even move your shoulder when you get out of bed. And usually the area where it's the sore, where you have most of the soreness is right about here. And it's on an area called the coracoid process of the scapula. And what's the coracoid process of the scapula? Well, your scapula is your shoulder blade. And as many of you know, it's a very flat bone, but at the top, there's a pretty good sized bony protuberance that actually comes through and you can actually feel it. If you go from the front delt and you move towards the midline underneath the clavicle, if you push in there and you feel around a little bit, you'll feel this little bony protuberance in there. And that's the coracoid process. So why does that get sore? Well, there's three pretty important muscles that attach, that have tendon attachments at that area. There's the pec minor, the short head of your bicep, and then the muscle that we're gonna talk about today called the coracobrachialis. Now, the coracobrachialis is probably a lesser known muscle. A lot of you may never have heard of that, but it has a tendon attachment at the coracoid process, and it's a small deep muscle that comes down and it attaches about halfway down the humerus on the anterior lateral side of the humerus. It does a couple different things. It being a small deep muscle, it adds to some shoulder stability. And as far as motion goes, the coracobrachialis assists in flexion of the shoulder, adduction of the shoulder, which is bringing the arm towards the midline, and then internal rotation of the shoulder. You put those three movements together and you're talking about chest work. You know, we're flexing, we're bringing the arms together, we're internally rotating. So this muscle, a lot of times, takes a lot of abuse when we do chest work. And over time, this muscle is gonna start to break down. It's gonna start to get microtraumas, it's gonna break down, your body's gonna react to that, and it's gonna start forming fascial adhesions in the coracobrachialis to try to help it out, to try to patch up some of that microtrauma. And what's basically gonna happen over time is that nice, stretchy coracobrachialis muscle is gonna become very fibrous, very leathery, and it's not gonna stretch. And when that muscle doesn't stretch, it's gonna start to tug. And where's it gonna tug? It's gonna tug up at the tendon attachment at the coracoid process. And I'm gonna let you all in on a little secret. Tendons don't like to get tugged on. That's right. Tendons do not like to get tugged on. They get very angry when you tug on them. It's gonna get very sore and very painful right in this area. And it can get to the point where I've had patients come into my office where they haven't bench pressed in 2 months because of pain up at the coracoid process. Other times it may just cause you you're not able to do certain chest exercises, or maybe you had to skip a few chest workouts. Well, that's why I'm putting together this video today. I'm gonna go over some awesome fascial release techniques for the coracobrachialis so we can break up that fascial adhesions, get that elasticity back into the coracobrachialis so that we can get back to bench pressing or push-ups or certainly get back to, so that we're not missing any chest workouts. So without wasting any more time, let's get right to it. Okay, so a couple things before we get started. First, we never wanna do any deep fascial release work right before we're about to work out. So this is not a technique that you use before going into the gym to do bench press. You know, that's not the time to do fascial release work right before the workout. I would recommend doing it after you get done working out or on an off day. Also, this isn't the type of treatment that we want to do if you're in the middle of a really flared up anterior shoulder issue here. If the coracoid process and the coracobrachialis tendon are super flared up because you just had a tough chest workout yesterday, you know, ice it down for a couple days, get it to simmer down a little bit pain-wise, and then try these techniques I'm gonna show you, because if it's super flared up right now, it's gonna be too sore to do what I'm gonna show you, so wait till it simmers down. This isn't something you do when you're having a, when you're at the peak of your anterior shoulder pain, okay? And lastly, make sure you warmed up when, before you're doing this type of work or any type of fascia release work. Don't jump straight out of bed in the morning and start doing deep fascia release work. Warm up, you know, go, you know, get on the treadmill for 10 minutes. Do something to get the blood flowing before you do this type of work, okay? All right, enough of that, let's get right to it. What are we gonna, we need the proper tool. This is a deep, small muscle. I'm using a Tai Chi mini ball from OcraMed Health. This thing is awesome. Look at the spikes and the nubs on this thing. It's gonna get deep into those muscle fibers. It's gonna get in between the muscle fibers, which is something that a smooth ball just can't do. And so that's what we're using to get into this coracobrachialis muscle. Now, a lot of people ask me, and I just real quick to go over it, is, you know, what's the difference between these mini balls and we also have some Tai Chi regular balls? The regular balls are just, are actually just a little bit larger than the minis, but they're harder also. So this is a little bit smaller than the regular size ball and it's softer. It's a good ball to start with for a muscle like the coracobrachialis. Once you get going with it, you can always move to the little bit larger, a little bit harder, regular size ball. But the mini is a good way to start with this, okay? The muscle's a little tricky to get to. It's deep, so we're gonna hit it from a couple different points. Now, as I mentioned, the tendon's off of that coracoid process, so you'd wanna palpate in, find that bony prominence. It's underneath the clavicle. It's to the midline of the front delt. And if you push in hard enough, you'll feel that bony prominence. So when you get to that point, you're gonna go a little bit lateral and down from that point. And that's where I'm gonna stick the ball first. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my shoulder into flexion by resting it on my leg. That's because if I hold it up, my deltoid is gonna contract and then it's too hard to get the ball down and deep. So if I wanna get the ball deep, I gotta get the deltoid to relax. So the way I'm gonna relax it is I'm gonna put the arm in a little bit of flexion but just rest it on my leg, so now the muscles are nice and loose in there. So that's the way we're gonna start. Then we take the ball, we find the coracoid process, we go a little bit down and off to the side, inferior and lateral. And I'm gonna put pressure right there and then I'm gonna pull towards that coracoid process like that. So I'm pushing in and I'm pulling up. So I'm trapping the tissue nice and firm. From this position now, I'm gonna do the release work as I trap the tissue. First, I'm gonna take my shoulder from flexion, I'm gonna bring it back into extension. As I'm doing that, I'm gonna turn my palm in this direction, which is external rotation, and I'm gonna keep extending back, and then I'm gonna bring it away from my body, which is abduction. So I'm basically doing the three opposite movements that this muscle performs. This muscle does flexion, adduction, and internal rotation. And so I'm starting with the arm, the shoulder internally rotated and flexed, and I'm gonna get the ball in there, I'm pushing, bringing it towards the coracoid process here, and I'm trapping the tissue. And then I'm gonna do the three opposite motions of what this muscle does. That's how we're gonna get it to release. I'm gonna start extension, external rotation, and then abduction. And as I'm doing it, I'm just pushing that ball in as deep as I can, stretching back, 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 and away, and then I'm gonna come back. Again, press in, pull towards the coracoid process, trap that tissue as tight as you can. Don't let go once you start the motion. Keep it in nice and tight. Extend, externally rotate, and abduct the arm. And just keep pressing in as hard as you can. And I'm gonna do five nice slow passes in that area, just like I just showed you. Nice and controlled, I'm just bringing it back, stretching as far as I can, and then I'm coming back. And I'm gonna do it five times. Then I'm gonna move down. Now the coracobrachialis is running down, it's actually right deep and next to the short head of the bicep. So if you're trying to find it, just flex your bicep a little bit. You can grab the bicep and the short head between your fingertips, and we kind of want to get it right next to that short head of the bicep. Now, you're catching some of the short head of the bicep, that's okay. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, the short head of the bicep has a tendon attachment up to the coracoid. That might be a little sore too from chest work. We're not saying that those other tendons may not be irritated. We were focusing on the coracobrachialis today, but you know what? If you're trapping some of that short head of the bicep along with the coracobrachialis, awesome. You know, it's just gonna help out. So flex the bicep, pinch the inside of the bicep, the ball's gonna go right in that area and kind of try to get it underneath, because that coracobrachialis is a deep muscle and trap the tissue here. Once again, you're pushing in, and then we're gonna pull up towards the coracoid process. So I'm trapping, I'm pushing in and pulling up, and I'm kind of underneath my pec right in this area, okay? Just like that. Once again, I have the arm resting like this. I've trapped the tissue. Again, I'm gonna bring the arm into extension. I'm gonna externally rotate, and I'm gonna abduct the arm and just go back as far as I can. Don't let any pressure come off of that muscle, and then bring it all the way back. Then again, repeat the process, push in, pull up towards the coracoid process, and again, extension, external rotation, and abduction. And once again, five passes. So I've done five passes here, five passes there. Can be kind of a sensitive area. This is a small, deep muscle. Gauge your pressure, put as much firm pressure as you can into that. Next up, we're gonna show you a little more of an intense release, or a little bit more of an intense stretch release on this muscle. This first part's a good way to do it. After you've done the five releases here and five here, you can move on to what we would consider like step two. All right, so if you've been making some good progress with the first techniques I went over, we're gonna just add some intensity to it by using a resistance band on the stretching portion of the movement. So I'm just gonna hold on to the band. I kind of have my shoulder once again kind of in flexion, but I'm letting my arm kind of dangle in the bands to kind of relax the arm. I'm gonna get that ball in the same spot. I'm gonna palpate. I'm gonna find that coracoid process. I'm gonna go a little bit down and off to the side from it, and then I'm gonna push in and pull towards that coracoid process. So I'm trapping the top part of that coracobrachialis muscle, and I'm trapping the tissue. Now from this position, I'm just gonna let the shoulder externally rotate, extend back, and abduct, and I'm gonna let that band give me that extra stretch through here as we do it. And I'm gonna, unlike the first technique, I'm gonna hold this for a 10 count as I go through the motion. So as I get into this stretched out position, I'm gonna 1001, 1002, 1003, I'm gonna count to 10 and then let it come back down. Again, I'm gonna trap in the same exact spot. I'm gonna extend, externally rotate, and abduct the arm. And again, I'm gonna just hold this position for 10 seconds. And I'm gonna do this five times on that top spot, like we did five times when I was sitting earlier in the video. And then again, when you get down near the short head of the bicep, flex the bicep if you have to, pinch it between your fingers so you can feel it. You can feel, if you get in deep enough, you can feel that coracobrachialis in there too. Trap that tissue, push in, and then pull up in this direction. Hold that ball, don't let it go. And again, externally rotate, extend, and abduct, and just stay in this position 10 seconds. Do all you can to keep that tissue trapped under that Tai Chi ball. Hold it for 10 seconds, and we're gonna repeat that five times. So this is a little more intense technique. I would start with the first techniques, see how it feels. It'll start loosening up that coracobrachialis. When you feel like you've gone as far as you can with that technique, move over to adding some more intensity with the exercise band. All right, so there you have it. You know, if you've been suffering with this type of a problem following your chest workouts, start on those techniques. Work them every other day. That way it gives the tissue a day in between to repair and to heal, but get working on it every other day. It's gonna take some time, so be patient. You know, that coracobrachialis didn't get leathery and tight and fibrous overnight. It took probably months and months and months. So it's gonna take some time to break up those adhesions. But you know what? It can be done. So just be patient and be consistent. All right? Hey, listen, I appreciate everyone who's been coming to my website, www.okramedhealth.com. You know, we have three different sizes of those Tai Chi balls for fascia release work. We have our SRI 2.0 massage gun. That's actually a perfect tool to use on an area like the coracobrachialis. You can put some of the smaller heads on it and get deep in there and let that massage gun do its thing on the coracobrachialis. Fitness programs, we offer on the website, video consults with myself for either 30 or 60 minutes. Anyways, lots of fun stuff. Check it out when you have some time. If you're enjoying these videos, please subscribe to my channel, OcraMed Health on YouTube. Questions about exercises or injuries, just leave a comment in the comment section below. I always do everything I can to get back to everyone. And don't forget, OcraMed Health is here to keep you fit forever.